Namaskar. Welcome to Sanmitram series, episode 6. Sanmitram presents series of conversations with youngsters, performing artists, professors, contributors in the field of art and culture across the globe. In this series, we converse with Sri Jay Chandran, who is a lecturer at the Center for Exact Humanities in IIIT Hyderabad. Sri Jayachandran holds 3 master's degrees in Bharatanatyam, philosophy, and history, respectively, although he has an engineering degree in electronics and communication. He shifted gear and moved into the world of art and artists. In this episode, he speaks with India Foundation, his brief perspectives on the research in Akashalinga. Very warm welcome to you, Professor Jayachandran. It's a pleasure to have you for Sanmitram series. Symbolic representation of Nataraja is celebrated all around the world. In fact, the representation itself has all the 5 elements in it: Prithvi, Apaha, Agni, Vayu, and Akasha. And these elements are revered so much that there are places of worship dedicated to each of these elements. Akasha, that represents the sound, is worshipped in Chidambaram. In fact, Chidambara Rahasyam itself makes a person interested to find out what that Rahasyam is. How do you perceive Akashalinga based on your research?
First of all, I'm so delighted to be part of this association. I'm so happy to speak with you, Pavitra, especially on behalf of on the auspices of India Foundation on a very important idea, an idea of huge gravitas called Akashalinga. It's interesting that, as you rightly said, Chidambaram is a temple, many Shaivites go, and Chidambaram is also called as Kovil. In Shaivite terms, if you say Kovil, it refers to Chidambaram. And if you say Periya Kovil, it refers to Thiruvarur. Though we also know Chidambaram is the name given to a temple, not, and now we start calling this entire city town to be called as Chidambaram. But the city town was originally called as Thillai. And Thillai means a shrub, a kind of a shrub called Exocaria golacha, botanical name. It generally has a characteristics to grow very close to the water bodies, especially freshwater water bodies. And also it's a kind of a thorny shrub. It's a forest of a thorny shrub called Thillai Vana. Generally, Vana, we know Aranya, Parvata, Giri, these are places. There are many such places, even Sangama, that I'm saying about the... There are places where the great sages and the seers congregated together to investigate on an idea of their interest. And one of the pivotal enigma of any of this intellectual faculty, I would say, the great scientists of India, if they call them as rishis, we call them as rishis. I mean, they were discussing about body. One of the terms to refer to body is linga. I mean, when you say Akasha linga, it can also be read as the body of the space. Yes, agreed. But there is a hidden, not hidden, there's an indicative term, that Akasha is the host for sound. As the special quality for Akasha is to host sound in it, the special quality of Vayu is to host touch in it, and the special quality or Sparsha, the special quality of Agni is to host color or Rupa in it, the special quality of Apa, water, is to host Rasa or taste in it. The special quality of Prithvi, is to host gandha, a smell in it. Because as human body, it's a confluence of all the five put together. And since it is so well harmonized for millennia, I'm saying a very small word, billions and billions of years it has taken to evolve into a form, a body and a mind like this. And to be, it is one of the best designs ever done in terms of organism existing. So is there a possibility to alleviate or isolate the entire being only as if it exists in the perimeter or in the atmosphere of only sound or only Akasha per se? In that sense, this is a project. Akasha Linga is a project. And they have the lab in which they were experimenting is their body. As Thirumular would say, Udambai Munnam Yilukendri Irundhen. I thought body is nothing. I found something so pertinent and important within body. Udambin Ulle Uttaman Koil Kondan Yendru. As the greatest master has been residing within Udambai Yan Irundhu Ombugindrene. I started protecting the body and fostering the body. In that sense, body becomes a main laboratory in which they have worked with. So Akasha Linga is a project being worked by many seers and sages for years together in this particular Thillaivana to isolate body in terms of sound and to understand what sound has an impact on the human body. I mean, there is so much of sound range. What human can pick up is with 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. They were trying to fine tune the body so that it can absorb further more sound ranges. And that particular technique, this project, the results, whatever they publish, it is published under a technical term called Chidambara Rahasya. The word Rahasya here is not secret, rather very, very important. Two major scientists who involved, are rishis who involved, sages involved, are Patanjali and Vyagrapada in this project. We know Patanjali is a seer, is a great name as such, which is generally represented with half serpent and half human being. We know a serpent is a four-sensory organed being. That is, it is a chaturendriya jiva, while a human is a shadendriya jiva, six-sensory organ being. Now, what is the confluence between a six-sensory organ and the four-sensory organ is the two missing in between sensory organs. So when you put Patanjali as a kind of a motif, it's the search of these two missing sensory organs between the serpent to being a human. That is the organ of sound. A serpent does not have a ear. It's constantly in search of a ear, it's sound. It doesn't have an organ to receive sound. So, kannai kaadaga konda, as Pambadi Chitthar says, it converts the vision into a distance related to absorb sound. Through distance, it absorbs sound. And entire body becomes the organ. The touch becomes the organ to absorb vibration so that it deciphers sound. So there's a constant search of sound. There's a constant search of, in turn, Akasha. But the other end is the human, which is Shadendriya Jiva. He has the sensory organ of Manas also with him. So this entire investigation is about sound and the Manas Prakriya. That's why Patanjali is also associated with a man who is associated with mind and body as the Yoga Sutra, and also with the idea of sound, grammar of the language, who wrote a commentary on it, and who wrote, this is not a historical Patanjali and we are addressing to, we know this, it's a parampara of a thought. And coming to Vyagrapada, a sage with a tiger claws, and that too a claw which has eyes in it. I mean, tiger is a being which has a tiger, or an entire feline being, I'm saying, the cat family, has a walk which is very, very poised, which means while you're treading on something, you have to be absolutely poised. You're also endowed with a kind of an eye. Vyagrapada is a sage who's endowed with eyes on his claws, so that he can look through darkness. here the word darkness is not used in terms of ignorance, rather density of knowledge. Looking through the darkness is one of the major characteristics of tiger's eyes. And looking through the unformed, dark existence, dense existence of this rahasya, this findings, he has to tread with it. He has to tread onto it and pluck the flower. As we say, Vyagrapada is a sage who got the boon to pluck flowers early morning in the Brahma Muhurta before being sucked by the bees. The bee here is the knowledge seekers. Any product, any great knowledge repository has to be taken and offered to the feet of the Great Almighty before even being deformed. For that, they need a very, very intense and a careful treading. So that is called Vyagrapada. This is a samambonam of what the Akashalinga as a project is, and about Patanjali and Vyagrapada, the two major seers who are involved in this project.
That was very interesting, Jayachandranji. So in this context, how do you view the Panchabhutas?
And Panchabhuta Linga installations we find in many, many places across India. Number one, because we also understand this investigation is towards understanding the relationship between senses and the human body. Coming to speak, one of the fundamental of these senses is touch. It is related to Vayu, Vayu Prakriya. And one of the Panchabhuta Lingas within the Chola Desa, the Chola territory, Sri Kalahasti is associated with Vayu Linga. And we know the major Nayanar, who's associated with this temple, is Sri Kannappa Nayanar. Kannappa has identified the idea of Linga by touch. And how did he identify it? When he lost the physical eye, and the inner eye opened. Kal is something to do with breath. Through his breath, lifting of the kal, lifting, placing the kal on the linga, he identified the linga. Through his breath, he identified the presence of a linga, not with a mortal eye. When he was ready to give up his mortal eye, some other eye opened within. And that revealed him the linga of the Vayu within himself. In Trivanika, we'll associate with taste. Taste, I mean, we know the story where the spider has been constructing a web, cobweb on the linga, and the elephant used to come and pour water on the same linga, destroying the cobweb. Now, what is so interesting about it is there is no stone linga there installed. It's a space being consecrated. It's an empty space in which the spider is spinning its web. But what is the cobweb? Cobweb is nothing but the saliva of the spider. Now, saliva is something to do with taste. Apa, and you know, the word apa, appulinga, appu, this is associated with rasa or taste. Through the taste, the linga is installed, through the saliva. And even what the elephant is, through its snout, pouring as water, it's also through its taste, through its saliva, it's mixed with its saliva. The installation of saliva, or I would rather say taste as an element in the linga within the body, that has been investigated in Trivanikavil. In Trivannamalai, the idea of color, the range of color, vision as a pillar of a column of light, infinite column. And, you know, Nityananda, Anadi, Malamukta, Swatantra, Sarvajna, Sarvavyapta, Sarvakarta, Akashalinga, I mean, the linga of the Agni, which is infinite column. Adi Andamillada, Jyoti Swarupam. That particular light revelation, the range of vision, what one can get, is identified as an experiment in Tiruvannamalai's Agni Linga. Prithvi, it's through Gandha. I mean, it's very interesting, through Gandha, through smell, it is identified in Kanchipuram and also majorly in Tiruvarur, because Tiruvarur is also another kshetram associated with Prithvi Linga. In Tiruvarur especially, the entire ritual or major thing is about fragrance, about Gandha. He's completely covered with flowers, Tyagaraja Swami. So in that sense, there is a dance of the senses on the human body. This dance of coming together all the senses and creating through that from the prithvi, apa, deyu, vayu, akasha, the respective gandha, rasa, rupa, sparsha, shabda, and their activities, strotra, tvak, chakshu, jihva, grana, vakpada, pani, payu, upastha, manas, buddhi, ahankara, chitta, jiva, all of them have their base from the panchabhuta. So slowly it gets constructed into the 96 tattvas, and the entire human body is a composite of all. And we know all of them are dances of the from the base. The substance on which everything is standing is on the panchabhuta, on which the sensory organs, on which its activity. Then the, you know, as we say, the karmendriya, the jnanendriya, and the antakarana, and on top of it, the entire construct of human existence. It's like a grammatical structure. It's a grammar. The base grammar is about the panchabhuta. Of five major categories. It's a school of five. And the school of five's major code is about Namah Shivaya. Namah Shivaya. It's a school which thinks that the entire cosmos can be reduced into the construct of fives. They work in fives. Such a dance of it is what is considered as the dance of Shiva. It's very directly connected. And this is, so the dance of Shiva is not just associated with the dance form, but the entire reality itself. Entire reality, and it's all its grandeur.
So Chidambaram one or many?
Interesting question, Pavitra. Tirumular, in his Tirumandiram, there is a chapter, it's a text of nine tantras, we know that. And in the ninth tantra, there's a chapter called Tirukkuttu Darisanam, or the darshana of the Tirukkuttu. The word darshana here, we also know, it's not necessarily looking, rather it means not looking the obvious, but looking beyond the obvious. Tirukkuttu becomes a darshana, like a Nyaya Darshana, Vaisheshika Darshana, Yoga Darshana, Sankhya Darshana, Mimamsa Darshana. Tirukkuttu becomes a darshana for Tirumular, in which one of the first poems he writes is Yengum Tirumeni. Everywhere there is sacred body. Or in its converse, another essence, I would say, if there is something called everything, that everything can be called as Tirumeni. Yengum Siva Sakti. If there is something called everything, and that everything can also be called as Shiva Shakti. Yengum Chidambaram. If there is something called everything, that can also be called as Chidambaram. Yengum Tirunattam. If there is something called everything, everywhere, the term associated with it can also be called as Tirunattam, or the sacred dance. Yengum Sivama Yiruttalal. As everywhere there is Shivam, Yengengum Tangum Sivan Arul Tan Vilayattadu. Everywhere his sacred play, his sacred game, his sacred dance is prevalent and established. So which clearly gives us an indication, Chidambaram is not one geographical location in a district in Kadalur, in Tamil Nadu, but technically, it is everywhere, anything, and it's another term given to reality, the existential reality. So Chidambaram is everywhere. There is no one Chidambaram. We can reconstruct or reconfigure Chidambaram, provided we intend to, and we kind of take a sankalpa to install Chidambaram wherever we want. There can be Dakshina Chidambaram, Uttara Chidambaram, wherever Chidambarams, could be many and many and many more.
Very wonderful to have heard your perspectives on Chidambaram and Akasha Linga Jayachandranji. On behalf of India Foundation, please accept our heartfelt thanks for joining in the Sanmatram episode. And we wish you continued success in your artistic journey.
It's my pleasure that I've been part of this journey, this small conversation. I'm so happy and delighted to be part of Sanmitra under the auspices of India Foundation. My pleasure, Raji. Thank you so much.